is Ashwin again. So in our last video tutorial, we saw how to create the simple modules and how to use them in other modules for the purpose of modularity. Now in this particular tutorial, we are going to take the concept of modularity even a bit further. So if you have seen, if you had an opportunity to have a look at the last video tutorial, we had created two modules. The first module was to be reused in the other module. So this is the module PROG01, where we are creating two classes, each with an initializer. And then we are creating the two objects, one for each class. And when we run this module, we get this output. Okay, it says created an object for class 01 and created an object for class 02. So these are two messages. So now when I open another module where I am importing the module PROG01. So here I can see the three statements: import PROG01, okay, and then later the last two statements, create an object each for class 01 and class 02. So we are using PROG01 dot as a prefix. Because the class 01 and class 02 do not exist in PROG02, they exist in PROG01. So when I execute this, I'm able to see the message for creation of objects twice. So the first two messages, they correspond to the code of object creation in the PROG01. So I have highlighted the part to which the messages correspond to, the part in the code to which the messages correspond. Okay, so now, and the last two statements correspond to the object creation code in PROG02. So now, as you can see, it is when I say import PROG01, it is importing the entire code in from PROG01 into PROG02. So usually whenever we work in real life projects, the part where we use the where we declare and define the classes is known as the place where we define the data constructs or programming constructs. Okay, and the programming logic, okay, in this case, which is nothing but the code for creating the object, it should be actually kept in separate code block, okay, than the place where we are defining the construct. Okay, so there is a facility in Python programming language so that these things are kept in the separate code blocks. So let's implement it. So that statement is known as if name equal to main. Okay, so now if I run this module, okay, so I can see the two statements corresponding to the two print messages corresponding to the statements where I'm creating the objects. Okay, and then let's now execute PROG02 module. And when I execute it, when I run it, I can again see only two sets of statement. Only two statements for creating the objects instead of four like we used to see earlier. Now this is because of the statement that we have introduced here. Okay, so whenever I'm saying if name equal to main, so this particular statement checks whether I am invoking the module directly or the module has been imported to some other module. So if I'm trying to invoke the module directly, okay, on the command prompt or by directly using the run option in whatever IDE I am using to run the code, to write and run the code, then only this block of code is going to execute. So it means that whenever I am launching the program on its own into the shell, or I am actually running the program on its own, then only this part, okay, which is listed under if name equal to main in double quotes, is going to execute. Otherwise, this part is not going to execute. Okay, So whenever I am saying import PROG01, it is only importing this part, okay? Because this is like the these are the programming constructs or data constructs in the class in the module, okay? So this is the basic use of the statement if name equal to main. So if you want to keep your business logic separate from your data constructs, so in that case you can use this. So whenever you just want to import your data constructs or the blocks of code to some other module, and you don't want your business logic to be exposed in some other module, this is a very good way to keep it separate. Okay, so and let's even implement the same thing here in PROG02. So let's say if name equal to main. Okay, and let's run the module again. So the output is going to be the same. We are just like adding this statement for the sake of consistency in our programs. Okay, and this is a more Pythonic approach of maintaining your code. So now the question arises that if I want to even make this the code which is the part of my business logic available to some external module only when I call it, then what to do? So for that there is another way. We can define a main method, def main, and we can add this code here. Okay, and let's call this method here main. Okay, now the output of the execution of program is going to be the same here. Okay, here it is actually creating two objects, class 01 and class 02. Okay, and let's try to run now PROG02. Let's run it. Run module. The output is going to be the same because we are creating the object separately in this module. Okay, now try to understand the flow of the program. So here I'm in the main method in this particular piece of code. I'm mentioning all of my business logic, and this the main method is then called in the if name equal to main block. Okay, so we can even call this main method into some other module where we are importing the module PROG01. So let's say PROG01.main. Sorry, let's say PROG01.main. Okay, so now this is gonna call the main method in PROG01 and we are going to get the same output. Saw that? Okay, so here we do not have to create another set of objects. Okay, so this is like the complete case of the modularity, like where we can modularize each and every block of the code. So here we are creating the separate blocks of code, okay, for our programming constructs. Even we are creating the blocks of code for defining our program logic or business logic, and then we can separately call these blocks of code into some other module. Okay, so let's even make this PROG02 a bit more Pythonic. Let's say def main, and let's say PROG01.main. Okay, and let us run the code again. Correct. Okay, so here in this case also, we are defining a piece of code which has the name main. Okay, so it's a function, and then we are actually calling this function in the if name equal to main block, and this main function is calling the main function from the module PROG01, which we are importing in the module PROG02. So this is a very convenient way of reusing your code over and over in other modules.